Okay, here we go. Past life regression. Ready? Rich, are you ready? Rich, you there? Dude, oops. Yeah, I'm here. Okay. All right. Now, okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give Rich the commands, and he's going to answer them, or he's going to give me the commands. One of us is going to answer them, and then we're going to talk about the mechanics involved in the answering and the coming up with the answer and how it all works, okay? So this is one more. This is an educational pass through the process. These are not the commands that you would follow in this little, gee, I wonder if we can do a past life regression on YouTube. That'll be next, okay? So Rich, fire away. Okay, here's your first question. How would you describe your Lemurian incident that you want to recall and check out? Are you life in Lemuria or what? Well, it has to be relatively specific for this research project here. So I'm just going to say a time I was feeling happy in Lemuria. Is that all right? Yeah, that's good. Okay, so Rich, close your eyes, relax, and I'm going to ask you the command, and you just tell me the first thing that pops up. Just grab it and we'll go with it, okay? All right. All right, it goes like this. Close your eyes, relax. Now, I locate a time you were feeling happy in Lemuria. Okay, I got a boat thing. Okay. Now, what he did was he looked, and something came up, but it was he didn't couldn't tell what it was. So he looked a little bit deeper and kind of got an impression of a boat, like a sailing boat, like a big old ship, sailing ship kind of thing. Viking looking sort of deal. And so he just gave that to me. He didn't query whether it was a past life regression, when it was, where it was this Lemuria, was this anything. He just closed his eyes and responded to this question. And something popped up and he gave that to me. And that's what we want to do with this research. And this is how I would do it if I was working with somebody live. Okay? So, again, this is a demo of how we would do it. Okay. The next question. When was that? Oh, you mean like when was that picture I saw, that mental image picture thing? Well, when was it? And you don't want a date. You don't want thousands of years ago so much as you want to. It was when I was looking at a ship from the shore. I was on a cliff, it looks like, seemed like. Okay? Yeah. Now, Rich isn't really good with video visuals. It's not like he gets these great visual imagery and things like that. But he does get these impressions or these little fast images. Like, if he thought of his car outside, he'd get an image of it. Just it's almost a no image kind of image. It's like a transparency, and it's there and it's gone. But you have all the data you needed when you looked at it. That's the kind of imagery that he gets. And some people will get vivid, great vivid imagery, and sometimes people will get hypnagogic imagery, and sometimes people will just, it'll be a full-blown reliving the experience. It's pretty awesome, but different people, different strokes. So he gave me the what he saw and felt when it was. When he was standing on a cliff, looking over into the ocean or the bay or whatever it was, and he saw the ship. So that's when it was, and that's all we need. So now I'm going to give him the next question. Okay, Rich? Yeah, go. All right. Move to the beginning of that incident when you were feeling happy in Lemuria. Oh, let's see. Ah, got it. Okay. Okay, what happened was he didn't like instantly get it. He had to kind of look at the, what's this about? And was the beginning a little earlier, a little later? He kind of looked back and forth, and just an impression came to him, an idea, a thought, and it was like, oh, this is my lover or friend or something is just arriving on boat, coming home, right? Okay. And you can see the emotional response in my face and his face when he saw that. So that helps us kind of get in touch with the idea that, hey, maybe this was really real. But see, you can't go into these, hey, I'm going to prove this is real, and how real was it and all that. No, normally when you do a past life regression, you're looking for The kind I have always done, you're looking for a traumatic incident, an reduction or emotional release. So we're not doing that in our research. We're not going to go into the heavy negative stuff and try to clear emotions so much as give you an example or a sampling of how you can possibly recall your Lemurian pleasure moment if you feel you had one to start with. Now, if you don't think you've ever been to Lemuria, you wouldn't want to do this particular release work or this particular past life regression because we are focusing on Lemuria. So it's got to be people that feel like they've been to Lemuria, or they lived in Lemuria, came from Lemuria, something like that. Okay? So, all right, Rich, let me see, where were we? Move to the beginning of that incident in Lemuria, experiencing good feelings. Yeah. Okay. What is the duration of that incident? When you can get the duration of an incident, you like put a front and a back on it, and it also helps you remember more of the details. It just kind of happens. So we're asking them what the duration is. Let me see. Yeah, it's the day my true love comes home. Yeah. And it starts, I guess, in the morning. And I sort of get a vague idea of a house or a place, living place. I guess it ends with after the party and a hangover. Yeah. All right. So you got the beginning and the end. Now, what is the duration of the incident? Let's see. Well, it seems like about 18 or 20 hours. You know, I got up early in the morning and she came home and it was gala festive activities all day long and all night long. And then, you know, got really good there after a while. And then we went to sleep. Happy, satisfied, kind of sleep. It was about 18, 20 hours. All right, good. So what's happening here is Rich, you know, this, it's just coming to him. It's as if it's imaginary. And that's the trick about this. You know, you can go, oh, bullshit. You know, hey, this is the way it works. I've done it many, 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 many times. And the value of it is not, it's not like you're treasure hunting and you're recalling where you buried your treasure, you know, 200 years ago. I'm sure, you know, some people get involved in that sort of game with this. But this is about emotional clearing or understanding your past, what you believe and feel was your past. And when you really work this stuff in great detail, you can really build up an entire big picture of your past in a particular age or era. And I've given people sessions where they were in a spacecraft and they crash-landed on Earth and got stuck on Earth. I mean, they crash-landed and died on Earth. And the next body they picked up was a human body, you see. So, and they go, oh, that explains a lot. So that's the sort of thing we're doing here. So Rich is already getting his stuff. It's starting to come to him. So let's see if we can get one or two more commands in here. It's the one time through sort of deal. Okay, Rich, what I'd like you to do now is move to the beginning of that incident and move through the incident to the point, the end point, about 18 or 20 hours later. And then I will ask you what happened. Okay? Yeah? Okay. And I'm going to do this really fast because I want to wrap this up under 15 minutes if I can. Let's see. Get up in the morning. Mm-hmm. I don't do this out loud so much. I can if I'm with a facilitator, but you can do it out loud or to yourself. And you just look what happens because you're going to report to the facilitator after. So I go, put on my best clothes, pretty happy, see my buddies, We go out there together. There's several people waiting for the ships to come in. It's almost like mail order brides or something. I'm getting a feeling like this is the brides are coming, maybe from another land or another island or something. Anyway, I'm looking forward to my girl. And so you get there, yeah, we click, dinner, party, dancing, music, then we retire, do all that romantic stuff, and then we go to sleep happy. So there. Very good. So now at this point I would say, okay, tell me what happened. Because normally he would do that in his head, right? And then so he would, again, one more time, he would give me the narration of just what he just said. So tell me what happened, Rich. Well, I got up, I did all that stuff I said, and normally I would detail it out once again. But for brevity on this video, let's just say what I said a minute ago is what happened. Okay? Right. Now, the next step is to go through the incident again. The commands are a little more brief, but we want to return to the beginning of the incident, check out the whole thing, and move through it again, and have him tell me what happens again, and then we go from there. And so that's the basics of how we do this. Okay? So I'm not going to have you do that right now because of the time's sake, but that's how we do it. Okay? So, Rich, did you get an idea or a feel for that? Yeah, as a matter of fact, I did. It was a happy time in Lemuria. That's what it seemed like, you know. So, yeah. Now, when you guys do it, or if you did it on yourself, you might have more personal oomph in it, you know. I purposefully avoided the in-time experiences of Lemuria. This isn't one of, hey, what happened at the end, and picking up the details of how the place sunk and all that. That wasn't what this was about. This is a pleasure moment to keep people out of hot water here emotionally when recalling stuff. Because if you recall some traumatic stuff and you don't clear the emotions that you stir up, you're going to feel kind of funky after the session. So we kept it light. So that's basically it. We'll do another one here with just the command so you can try it, okay? Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Thanks.